And joining us now to take a further look at this issue is a legal practitioner, Festus Keyamo. You're welcome to Newstrack. Now, as you may have observed in the last report, a number of cases... Okay, I'll take my question again. As you may have observed in the last report, a number of cases bordering on extrajudicial killings have occurred in Edo State recently, and those behind it are yet to be identified. Now, what do you think about the obstacles to getting to the root of these cases?
Well, the obstacles are very clear. It's a situation where you say the killers should look for the killers. Situation where the killers are looking for the killers, you will never find the killers. You are indicting the police, there's some kind of camaraderie and esprit de corps within the police. Most of them are guilty of these incidents, these acts of brutality, excessive use of force leading to the death of innocent citizens. And in many cases, apart from excessive use of force, it's just outright murder where they shoot innocent citizens dead. And so you now see a situation where you're asking their superiors, in most cases, who are bent on covering up their colleagues to fish out the killers. And so that is first and foremost a problem we face in this kind of situation, where you are saying that their colleagues should bring their colleagues to justice. So I think maybe we should adopt a different approach to such matters where law enforcement agencies are accused of extrajudicial killings. Perhaps a different agency should take up such matters. If the police engages in such an act, perhaps maybe the State Security Service should look into it and vice versa, as the case may be. So, because you know, you have situations where they have proved to be very irresponsible in such investigation. I've done one or two cases like that where we kept going and going and going, and then they would never bring their own colleagues to justice.
But Mr. Keyamo, I need to interrupt you there.
The young man who the Air Force killed.
Mr. Keyamo.
Pardon me?
The Inspector General of Police had made it clear several times that it will no longer be business as usual, and he intends to abide to the rules of engagement. So, and you still say that the police, they can't fish out their own when their top boss has made it clear that it will no longer be tolerated?
Well, we need to see action on this in this instance. I know Solomon Rasa very well. We've known many for many years. He's a very diligent cop, a very responsible, highly diligent policeman. And so I hope to change under him. But all we have heard now are instructions he has given. We need him to also implement these instructions. We need to see action. Various inspectors general of police, inspector general of police in the past, they have been given options, given such orders, but nothing came out of it. So we need to see a different approach to such matters this time around.
Okay, now let's leave Edo State. There have been calls on the president to revisit previous cases of killings in the country, especially the assassination of the late Chief Bola again. Now, what do you make of this? Are we waking up a ghost from the past, or we should just let sleeping dogs lie?
Well, we can't let sleeping dogs lie. Killers, anybody who is a killer or who is a murderer, should not know peace until he's fished out. Luckily for us, the present IG was one of the major IPOs in the case of Bola again, Solomon Arase. He was one of the top policemen who investigated that case, and so he's and good enough that this issue is coming up at a time now he has risen up to become the Inspector General of Police. I was deeply also involved in that investigation and that case also. So it is very good that such cases must be resurrected. All over the world we hear of cases where cold cases at times where after 40 years or 30 years the killers are fished out. Nigeria should not be different. In the annals of time, it could have happened 12, 14 years ago or so, it happened. So in the annals of time, that is very fresh. We have cases of 30, 40 years that are unearthed and the killers are fished out. I support such a move, and they should get a crack score, actually, in the police department.
Okay, now let's talk about the appointment.
Cold cases, like we have in America and other places. They should take out cases. Pardon me?
Okay, Mr. Keyamo, I was about to talk about another issue, the appointment of service chiefs. I know you insisted that they be cleared by the federal lawmakers. Now, how do you feel about what happened yesterday with the confirmation of the security chiefs by the Senate?
It was a fight that was very happy to behold, where the entire military command was subjecting themselves to civilian authority, to a democratic institution like the Senate and then the House of Reps. This has always been my position. I've been on this battle for the past 6 or 7 years until I went to court and got a court judgment in my favor, in the favor of the country, and in favor of constitutional order and democracy. So it was a sight to behold. I was extremely glad that the present president, and I think even President Jonathan also complied with the court order, but I was extremely glad that President Buhari has continued in such fine manner to obey the rules of law and to strictly follow constitutional and legal provisions.
Thank you so much, Mr. Festus Keyamo, a legal practitioner. We've been exploring several issues from security to extrajudicial killings to appointment. Thank you for joining us on News Track. Well, coming up.